Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. This is your boy, J-Mad, and you're listening to Coffee and Conversation on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it's supposed to do. Good morning to each and every last one of you all. Let me check the chat room. Good morning, Nurse Rachel, Nurse Lee, I think I said that right, and Leah. Nurse Leah, I need to go get my glasses. Good morning, Dr. Stewart. Good morning to my warriors out there. Good morning, Miss Yogis. They said Miss Yogi is with you all out there at Winship. All of my warriors out there at Emory Winship Cancer Center out there fighting that good fight. Y'all making it do what it do. I see you swinging out hard. Keep fighting, keep fighting, keep fighting. Don't let this thing beat you. You got it. Good morning to each and good morning. I think Dr. Washington may be listening in. Good morning to you all. It is a great, 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 great day. It is a great, 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 great day. There are many ways to look at it. Yes, it's the sun is going to be out. I had to peep out the window. The sun is going to be out today. It might be a little chilly, but the sun will be out. One of the things I was, yesterday, I noticed after the day before yesterday, we was under a freeze warning here in Atlanta. Believe it or not, we was in under a freeze warning. And I was yesterday morning when I got up, I was going to the store. And on my way to the store, going out of the neighborhood, I noticed that my neighbor has this huge cornerstone, what they call cornerstones, in his yard. And under it, he kind of circled around it, put a little flower bed or something around it, and it's under a tree. Everything was dead. Everything was dead around it. Even the leaves, the leaves are falling off of the tree. The leaves are falling off of the tree. And as the leaves are falling off the tree and everything around it, the grass is dead, I notice one single rose. It has a rose bush. But underneath it, it was a perfect red rose still growing. It was by itself. It was lonesome. However, it was the most beautiful thing, the most beautiful sight I ever seen. Everything around it seemed like it was fading away, but it refused to die. It refused to give up. It showed the world, I got one more good one in me. You may not believe me. You may not say, oh, you may doubt me. You may say, no, you don't have, it's time for us to move on. No, this one said, I got one more good one in me. I think that's how we all should be. I think that that's how we all should live our lives. No matter what's going on around us, no matter how things are looking around us, we have to say, you know what? I'm doing this for me. I understand that it's time for the leaves to move on. I understand that it's time for the grass to move on. I understand that people are making adjustments in their wardrobes and all of this thing. They're turning on the heat. But I'm a rose, and I'm only supposed to bloom in the spring and summer. It's freezing outside, but I want to do it one more time just for me. I think that's how we need to be. You know, in life, we find ourselves accommodating to our surroundings. We find ourselves accommodating to our surrounding. In the Marines, we used the word adapt. We adapt. We were really great at adapting to our surrounding, fitting in into our surrounding. It's good when you're in the military. It's a form of survival. It is. But here in our lives, our daily lives, sometimes it's good to stick out. Sometimes when things around us are fading away and it looks like this is happening, that is happening, this is happening, I tend to like to go back to my 20s, when I was vibrant, when the life was just all the way in front of me, and I relive those moments. And people look at me, why do you have so much energy? Why are you always just on 100? Because I made a decision that I'm going to live my fullest life. Yes, I may not be able to do it as fast as I want it. I may not be able to do it as many times as I want it. But I got, just like that rose, I have one more good one. And as long as it's another day, I have one more good one in me. You know, we get so consumed with our surroundings and what's happening in our surrounding that we forget to live. Yesterday, I announced on my show a thing that I was going to put out. And on my show yesterday, I told them this. I said, I found the secret to being happy. I really found the secret to being happy. Now, I didn't just think of this on my own. It was in my meditation, the different meditations that I do to start my day off with. And even during the day, I find myself finding different things to meditate with, whether it's finding motivational speakers, listening to life coaches, reading the Bible, listen to sermon, listen to music, find ways to motivate myself and sit around and motivate myself. and I heard this. The reason why we are unhappy, the reason why we are simply unhappy, I want y'all to get this. I'm trying to make it slow, so I don't want to rush it. The reason why we are unhappy, simply put, is because life is not happening the way we want it to happen. Boom. Boom. Good morning, Jackie. Good to have you on the show. The reason why we are unhappy is because life is not happening the way we want it to happen. That is very simple. We can blame it on a lot of different situations or a lot of fruit from that statement, but the bottom and the foundation to why we are unhappy, think about it, is because life is not happening the way we want it to happen. Relationships go bad, we become unhappy. Health goes down, we become unhappy. Financial situations goes down, and these are areas that's not meeting the standard for what we want for our lives, so we become unhappy. So how do we reverse this, or how should we use this information? It's real, real simple. It's real simple. Simply live life. Period. Simply live life. Period. And whatever comes our way, watch this, whatever comes our way, be able to say, this is happening to me. Oh, this is an adjustment into what I was looking for. Since this is an adjustment, instead of feeling unhappy, I'm going to move on from it and grow from it. Just like that rose. That, I guarantee you, that rose that I saw the other day, it wished that it could stay 70 degrees. 75 degrees. I guarantee you that rose wish it stayed 70 to 75 degrees. It didn't have to be worried about being withered by the sun. It doesn't have to worry about being chafed by the coldness in the air. It at 70 to 75 degrees, it can just thrive. On a good day, it could just simply be beautiful. But that rose decided, I don't care how cold it is out here. I don't care what that tree has decided to do. The leaves on the tree decided to do. I don't care what the grass decided to do. The rose says, I am going to grow anyway. I am going to grow anyway. You have an option. You have an option in life to enjoy it or not to enjoy it. Those are the only questions or options on the test. It's going to come your way whether you like it or not. But it's all by how you perceive, or all it's all about how you accept what happened or is happening or will happen to you. I have this thing. I used to struggle in the area. If you ever wanted to see me back in the day, if you ever wanted to see me unhappy, let my money get messed up. If you ever want to see me unhappy, let my money get messed up, and I would lose it. I would become so disconnected, so unhappy, so frustrated, so frustrated. But then I began to change my mind, and I began to look at the things that's more important than money, the things that I had. And when I was able to conquer that area in my life and not worry about money and not having money, my situation with money changed. It shifted because I didn't allow money or the lack of money to control my happiness. If I didn't have money to go out and do things, I found something at home. I fell in love with doing puzzles. I fell in love with doing different things around the house. I found the creative side of doing things. When I figured out that because something looks like it's dying in my life, what it means is I have to find another way of doing it. In other words, I had to find another way to be happy the way money would have made me happy. Because happiness is on the inside of you. Stop carrying things around. Stop carrying things around that don't belong to you. Stop harboring those feelings and those emotions on the inside of you. The things that make, because things aren't happening. So you instead of letting it go and moving on and growing from it, we carry that bag with us. You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com.
Your face. baby back, mama's, yeah.
Let's go, let it go, let it go, let it go.
All of my book back, lady.
Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go.
Zip line back.
You're listening to Coffee and Conversation on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. My desire is this. My desire is that all of us get to a point and a place in life that we are like the trees outside. I know I just threw you off for a loop, but I'm going to tie it all in. We are like the trees outside. If you were to walk outside today, you'll look at majority of the trees out there and you'll see that the leaves has fallen. And if you didn't understand what was going on, when you initially look at the tree, you would think that the tree is dead. The reason why you think the tree is dead, because there are no leaves on it. However, the tree had to adjust. Let me tell you what happens to trees in the fall. It's not that the tree is dying. The tree went into survivor's mode. And because it knew the shift in the season, the tree had to let some things go in order to survive, in order to make it to the next season. So what the tree does is it loses its leaves so that it can conserve the water and the nutrients that it's going to need through the winter. Not every season in our lives is going to be a good season. Sometimes we have to learn how to survive the storm. If we learn how to survive the storm, we would know the difference between being happy and unhappy. We would know the feeling of knowing I am still happy because I'm still surviving. I may have had to let some things go. I may have had to let some things drop off of me. I may have had to give up some things, but I'm still surviving. It is all for the benefit of me being selfish. Me being in survival mode. Sometimes, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to lose some things, and it's okay. It's okay. It's a part of surviving. So this morning, my brothers and sisters, all of my listeners, I want you to understand that in this new season, you may have to let some things go. But the thing that you should not let go of is your life. It's your happiness. Those are things that you should not let go. You should not let go of being happy. Always stay happy. Even though things aren't going the way that you want it to. Even though things aren't moving in the way that you wanted to, yes, sometimes life is unfair. Yes, sometimes we have to ask the question, this is unfair. Why me? Sometimes you may have to ask that. But after you ask it, go find out why you were chosen to go through it. And then go through it. Biblically speaking, there's a verse in the 23rd Psalm, yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow. He did not say, yea, though I am in the valley. He said, I'm walking through it. You have a choice today to walk through it. Go through the process. Because on the other end of the process is a better tomorrow. On the other end of the fall and the winter, That tree outside, leaves will grow again. But that rose that's out there that's still blooming, he's just showing how beautiful it is. It will soon fade away, but it will come back the next season even more beautiful. That tree, that rose bush, will produce something even more beautiful. That rose, that single rose out there, will last for a little bit, but it will fade away. But that tree, that rose bush, will have to make a decision. do I keep living? And the way that I keep living is that I am going to adjust so that I can survive. My good people, my friends, I ask you to do this. When bad things or unexpected things happen to you, don't let it change your attitude. Don't allow it to make you unhappy. Just because it's not life is not happening the way you want it to happen. There was a technique that we was taught in when I was in bodyguard school. Expect the unexpected. In order for me to stay on my toes, in order for me to move from one situation to the next situation to the next, I had to always expect the unexpected. Life is just like that. I understand that we wrote a book and we said, this is how my life is going to turn out. You remember when you was a kid? I'm going to have this job. I'm going to be married. I'm going to have these many kids. I'm going to live in this type of house and I'm going to drive this type of car. And then life happened. And life didn't turn out the way you wanted it to happen. And it caused you to simply be unhappy. It's time to reverse that. And look at it as the things that has happened to me, whether good or bad, is the ingredients to making me into a cake. Think about it. An egg is nasty. Flour is nasty. Just picking up a stick of butter and eating it is nasty. But when you begin to put all of those ingredients into a bowl and stir it up and mix it up, all of the good tasting stuff and all of the bad tasting stuff, you put it in a bowl, you stir it up, and then you put it in the fire. You put it in the heat. Yes, life is heat. Happiness comes when we don't add that ingredient, when we don't accept that one ingredient. When you pour that cake out of the oven, it is the best thing you ever tasted. You forget about that they put a raw egg in there. You forget about the flour that they put in. All you know is that you are enjoying a nice cake. Your life is the same exact way. Yes, you're going to have to add some negative ingredients. Yes, you're going to have to be put in the fire. You're going to have to feel the pressure. You're going to have to feel the heat. But on the other side of it, because I've decided to remain happy, that on the other side of this process, things will work out for me. Things will make me look like that rose outside, as beautiful as I want to be. Thank you all so much for listening to Coffee and Conversation this morning. It has been my pleasure, my honor to hang out with you all this week. I will see you all next week, next Tuesday and Thursday. Look, Emory Winship Cancer Center Warriors, y'all keep fighting. I see the smiles on your faces. I see the smiles on your faces. And understand, we are not going to be a one-man band. We are going to do this thing together. So I'm dedicating this to all of my warriors out there at Emory Winship Cancer Center. This is Old Dominion One Man Band. It's a song that talks about, if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it with you. Hey, warriors, we're going to win this fight together. It's all good. It's definitely, definitely all gravy. I'll see y'all next week. I'll let you, boy. It's all good. I'll...
Been flying solo for so long, nobody singing the harmony. Up there just me and my shadow, no bass, no guitar, no tambourine. Then I found you like a melody, and you were singing in the same key as me. We had them dancing in the streets. I don't wanna be a one-man band, I don't wanna be a rolling. rolling stone alone, putting miles on a rundown van. Maybe we could take our own show on the road. I'll lay down the beat, you carry the tune. We'll get tattoos and we'll trash hotel rooms. Baby, take my hand. I don't wanna be a one-man band. I wanna run down your wild dreams, and I wanna chase every high with you. Count every rip in these old jeans. We'll never learn how to sing the blues. If I'm gonna be famous, girl, I wanna be famous with you. We got our own little groove. I don't wanna be a one-man band. I don't wanna be a rolling stone alone, putting miles on a rundown van. Baby, we can take our own show on the road. I'll lay down the beat, you carry the tune. We'll get tattoos and we'll trash hotel rooms. Baby, take my hand, 'cause I don't wanna be a one-man band. When the spotlight goes cold, the curtains come down, chairs are all stacked and there's no one around, and nobody's paying, we'll still be playing. I don't wanna be a one-man band. I don't wanna be a rolling stone alone, putting miles on a rundown van. Baby, we could take our own show on the road. I'll lay down the beat, you carry the tune. We'll get tattoos and we'll trash hotel rooms. Baby, take my hand, 'cause I don't wanna be a one-man band.